Hello, my loves. How are you? Hope all is well with you guys. Got a lot to tell you. I got my hair cut, so I don't know if I've been on since I got my hair cut, so I got that chopped. Took off about 7 inches, I think it was, off my hair. So it feels a lot better, so I'm loving that. I decided the other day to just, I wanted to drive, I just wanted to go, I just wanted to take a trip. So I decided to drive to Herkimer, New York. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of the Herkimer Diamond, but the only place that you can get the Herkimer Diamond is in Herkimer, New York. So I took a drive. It was about a 3-hour drive one way, and it was amazing. I went by myself, and I went to the mines. I went to the Herkimer Mines. And it was awesome. The only thing is, I want to go another day when it's not so hot, because you go and you pound on rocks to find the Herkimer diamonds. And I found a little teeny tiny piece, and I put it in with the stuff that I got. And I decided to buy, what you can do is you can buy a bag. And the bag is quite big. It was probably about, I would say, maybe about this big. And it's all full of rocks and sand and the whole nine yards. And so I bought that. It was $25, and you sift it like you would in the old mining days, and you sift it and you get things out of this bag. So what I got out of this bag was amazing. I got this, and I believe that this, I'm not sure what all these are yet. I got to do a little bit of research, but I think this might be either opal or a topaz. But that was the crystal that was in one of the bags that I got. Isn't that gorgeous? So I got that. So there's one out of the bag. I got some arrowheads. Very beautiful. And I'm not gonna go through all of these, but I'll just kind of show you. That selenite. I got two pieces of selenite. Let me dump these out here. Got two pieces of selenite. If I can find it. Yep, here it is. There's the other piece. So two pieces of selenite, which is great for cleansing. Let me look at my little chart here. I believe this might be citrine. So I got a nice big chunk of citrine. This one, I believe, might be green quartz or amazite. I'm not sure yet. Like I said, I got to do a little bit more research here. There's another piece of that. Another little piece. Got my quartz. Couple pieces of quartz. That looks like the pink quartz, rose quartz maybe. And this would be your amethyst. And I got some of the fossils. They came with fossils too, and I'm not sure. I believe these are the brachiopod. I don't know if you guys can see them. Two of those. More lavender. Or amethyst, I'm sorry. Some more clear quartz. Another clear quartz. I mean, you got a lot. Here's another amethyst. I got shark's teeth. Got quite a few of those in the bag. I mean, it was really neat place to go. It really was. I suggest if you know you're into crystals and stuff, it's a neat place. But don't go if it is hot like it was when I went. So I'm trying to find some different ones. I got fool's gold. A couple little pieces of fool's gold. And then this one is an Ortho Sierras. Got a couple of those. Obsidian. This is the little piece that I got when I mined, when I did my mining. That is a Herkimer diamond. You guys can see it. I'll show you my bigger one. But like I said, it was too hot. It was like 90, it was almost 100 degrees. And what you do is you go out in this quarry. And this quarry, you go out and it's nothing but rocks and dirt and clay. And it is so hot sitting on those rocks when it's that hot. So I didn't stay out there real long because, like I said, it was unbelievably hot. Here is a green quartz. And then this one, I believe, is a, I can't even say it, Chrysocolla. So I'm not going to go through all of these, but yeah, there's some really, oh, here's the other piece of fool's gold. Can you guys see it? Isn't that cool? It's got the gold. So, but that is what I got, and I got quite a bit. I mean, this table's like full of nice little crystals that I got. Let's put those back in the box here, and then I'll show you what I got, what else I got. There's so many little pieces, guys, that you, when you sift, you get the little teeny tiny pieces, which is awesome. Let me just pick these up and we'll get into, oh, here's a little Herkimer diamond too. Little baby, I don't know if you guys can even see it. If you guys can see it, a little tiny, tiny one. It's right there. Okay, so then you can buy things from the gift store. So I got, you get this little baggie and it's $4.99 and you can put as many crystals in here as you want, as long as the bag closes. So I got, and I'm not sure what all of these are either. So I believe this is a Septarian. Not sure what this one is. I'll have to, like I said, I have to do my research, guys. Isn't that beautiful? I think that might be another Septarian. This one looks like a tiger's eye to me. Not sure what this one is. Not sure what that one is. This one, I believe, might be amethyst. Another amethyst. Like I said, I'm not sure what these are yet, so. That looks like a smoky quartz to me. This looks like a red jasper. And then another one. So those are the ones that I got in the bag for $4.99. And then I'll show you my other two pieces, and that's all I got. Let me put these back so I don't lose this stuff. Okay. let's show you this one first. Here is my, look at that, guys. It's all little Herkimer diamonds in there. Isn't that amazing? I love it, it's so beautiful. So I got that. And then my last piece I got. Now, if you guys ever want to go to the mine, all you do is go on the internet and look up Herkimer Diamond or Herkimer New York, and it's right there. But here is my Herkimer Diamond, guys. Look at that. This is uncut. Isn't that gorgeous? Very, very clear, Herkimer. Absolutely love it. But yeah, I want to go again. I want to go, when I have time to mine. They give you a mallet, and you go and you pound on the rocks. And, like I said, it was too hot at that day, that I did it. And, so I didn't spend a lot of time doing that. So, but anyway, and then they give you a little sheet with the different, you know, the different gemstones and fossils that you get. Oh, one more thing I got. I got a Herkimer Diamond Mines pen. And all of those are little Herkimer diamonds in there. It's not really showing very well, but yeah. And then it lights up. See the little diamond. Isn't that pretty? I had to get it. So, but anyways, let's get on with what's going to be going on with you guys for July. All right. July. This is the biggest news that's going to happen this month for you guys is Jupiter is the planet of plenty, right? It is going to be moving back into Aquarius this month, and it's going to be moving in until December. So this is good news for all the fire signs, the Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. It's also good for air signs. So Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius. It's going to bring good luck to everyone, not just the air signs or the fire signs. It's good luck for everyone. It's going to give you second chances at things. It's good for travel. It's good for study. It's good for teaching. It's good to expand on your philosophies. So that's a good, you know, that's nice that that's coming in, and it's going to be here till December, guys. So take advantage of that, you know, if you so be. The new moon this month is going to be on the 9th in the United States and the 10th. And it's going to be in Cancer. Okay. So that's going to deal with shedding, shedding stuff, shedding those things that no longer serve our purpose. It's going to be, it deals in sexiness. So it's going to, you know, you're going to feel a little bit more on the sexy side or show that sexy side of yourself. It deals in home, you know, your home. It's going to bring, dynamic. Things are going to get, maybe a little sexy this new moon. Then the full moon is going to be coming in. It's going to be coming in Aquarius on the 23rd and the 24th. Okay. That deals with karma, maturing, lessons to be learned, and commitment. Okay. So those are just a little bit of things that are going to be happening, with your moon. So let's get on with your readings and see how things are going to be going for you guys with your readings. I'll be right back. Hello, Virgos. Hope you guys had a great month. As you can see, my month was pretty interesting. So, had a great time. Gonna give these some shuffles and see what's going on with you guys. These five shuffles. There's four. Don't mind, my hair is gonna be blowing around. I got the fan on. It is so muggy today. I do not like this weather at all. I'm not a fan of muggy weather. I like fall. Fall weather. All right, let's see what's going on with you guys. Put these down here. Angels, guides, and spirits, what is it that my Virgos need to know for July of 2021, please? Grab the one on the floor. Usually one falls on the floor. So you're coming out slowly but surely. One more. All right, let's see what's going on. First cards I'm going to read are your inner cards. These are the cards that are here now or the cards that are coming in very soon. I have the hand in hand, King of Hearts. This indicates that a friend of yours, a friend that you have is going to turn into more than just a friendship. It's going to turn into maybe a love interest. You're going to have a lot of love between you. And you're going to have, it's going to be very warm and loving relationship that you have. If you are married, you're married to your best friend. Three of Hearts. This is happiness. Happiness and popularity are coming in your way or are here now. You're a very popular person. People love to spend time with you. Six of Hearts is the house, success in all of your ventures. You're going to have a happy home life. And it's going to be happy and prosperous. So that is awesome. It can also predict a marriage. The Three of Clubs. Tree of Life, good health. Good health, and you're going to be fulfilled to your highest hopes. Awesome. Nine of Diamonds. This is the heart. Great joy. Great joy is coming in to you. It's very near. Calm things. Things are going to start to calm down for you. Things aren't going to be so hustle bustle and rushed. So you're going to have some calmities coming in. So that's awesome. Six of Clubs is the Lightning. This is a surprise that's coming into you. And it's going to be coming in fairly quickly. It's going to be coming in like lightning, very fast. The Eight of Diamonds. This is the broken glass. And this is, bad luck. When it comes to gambling, putting your names in drawings, playing the horses, casinos, lottery, things along that nature, you're not going to be as lucky as you once were in that aspect. Okay, the next cards I am going to read are your outer cards. These are the cards that are sitting out there, and they are the cards that are waiting to come in. I have the Book. Jack of Hearts. You guys are going to have a discovery. You're going to find out a mystery or a secret about somebody for the best. So whatever you find out about this person, it's for the better. That secret or that mystery about that person you're going to discover. The Nine of Spades. This is the Rose. You're beautiful. You're going to have rugged health. Beauty and rugged health are there for you. The Ten of Hearts is the Bouquet of Flowers. You're going to have a long and a happy life. So that is awesome. And if children are near, Which the children is the next card I have here. You're going to have honors and fame. So you're going to be honored for something or have some kind of fame in something. I have the Queen of Diamonds is the children. If you don't have children, this is a good indication that you may have children or if you're wanting children. If you don't want children, then spend some time with some children. You know, the eyes of a child, see things through the eyes of a child, right? That newness of things, you know, show your love and generosity towards children. If you have children already, keep them close. Keep them close to you. Show them how much you love them and care for them. The Nine of Hearts. This is the ship. Riches is going to come to you and it's going to, wealth and you're going to get, can I talk today? You're going to gain riches through an inheritance of some sort or a trade industry, working with your hands, doing something with your hands. So that money is going to be coming into you, but it's going to be coming in that inheritance or working in a trade industry. Ten of Spades. That's the rod, family quarrels. You're going to have some family quarrels coming up. And it usually starts with somebody that is not close. Somebody that is a distant relative or maybe not live in the same town as you. But they're the ones that's going to start stuff. The Eight of Hearts is the cat. That's flattery. Flattery is coming into you. Somebody is going to flatter you. Somebody is just, you know, wants to spend time with you. So you have that little secret admirer kind of. The Queen of Hearts. That's the ring. This is a rich and a happy marriage. But you maybe have been disappointed in love. So it takes you some time to get to where you can trust somebody. Know somebody and give your heart to somebody. So, but this is, you know, you will have a rich and a happy marriage. Okay. So that is your inner card. There is your main reading, I should say. Okay, let's do these cards. Let's talk to the universe. Is there anything that you would like to add to that reading, universe, or to, clarify with that reading I just did for my Virgos, please. A lot of people have been getting solitude. I have the island, I have iceberg and the mountain. So they want you to spend time by yourself, but spend some time getting to know you. Sometimes we forget that we are the most important person. You know, we have to love us so that we can love others. So you have to do that soul search and you have to look inside and find out what it is that you really want. What do you want? How do you want your life to be? You can get that, you know? You've got to work towards it, but it's there for you. Don't stay hidden. Don't stay locked into a certain, you know, like, yes, we've had COVID for the last year, right? Get out there. Get out there. Open up. You know, don't stay hidden in your house or hidden behind a wall or hidden. Open up. Get out there. Do things. You know, those possibilities are out there for you. You guys have the strength to do this. You have the strength to overcome the things that aren't working right for you. You have that strength to change what it is in your life that you need to change. Okay. Thank you, universe. All right, let's talk to spirit. Spirit, give me a card that Virgos need to hear for July, please. Card they need to hear for July. Dearest you, we need you to know that you can change things miraculously for you and everyone and make things right. It's never too late. Forgiveness is about releasing yourself from the burden of an old story, one in which you were a victim of someone else's actions or your own. You don't need to carry this around. You can set yourself free. Even advocating for good because of this experience requires your forgiveness to be effective. Forgiveness is never about condoning things that were done. It's about letting yourself off the hook from carrying the burden. Resentment and hurt are like viruses and that spread to others. And that is the opposite of what you really desire, right? Imagine what your life would be like without the burdens that you carry when you do not forgive. You can do it. Everyone over here believes in you and adores you. So don't carry those burdens around anymore. Forgive yourself, forgive others. You know, don't carry that around. That's a heavy burden to carry around. You know, you just need to let go and move on. Okay. All right. One last card for you guys, and this is your reflection card for the month. Give me a reflection card for my Virgos, please. A card they can reflect on for the month. My life works beautifully. My life works beautifully. Everything in my life works now and forevermore. Make it work. You know, make it work. Put in that little bit of work, right? My life works wonderfully, beautifully. I love it. I hope this helps you guys. Remember, this is a general reading and it may not resonate with all of you. So be sure to check out your sun, your moon, and your rising readings also. It gives you that better picture into your full reading. I love you guys. I hope you have a wonderful and an absolutely amazing July. And I'll see you next time.